Log recording. It's 1:36 in the morning. It is May 27th, 2022. It is Friday. One more day before my brother's anniversary of his birthday. Yeah. Not exactly looking forward to it in the first place. I had someone online, actually a few people online, that are still going through the grieving process, and someone fresh. They lost their mother. I know how that feels. I'm just trying to take care of my own and myself. Not exactly the easiest thing. But still. Dealing with the loss of a parent and then not knowing what to do afterwards. That's trickier than hell. There are emotions that one has to go through that in the numbness of the feelings at this point, and not to mention how the brain is working, one has to function enough to make certain decisions necessary to take care of the deceased. And you have to look at it, and I hate to say this, but sometimes you have to look at it kind of coldly a little bit, because your brain has to work on an automatic basis here. That meaning that you have to make decisions that are going to be hard as hell. Now, when you have people that care about you and are working with you to basically find out how to deal with your situation, you can lean on them, hopefully. If they're close and trusted and offered to help. Backup right now. I had a Leon friend or two. They helped pay for David's cremation. My mama, on the other hand, she had built up enough life insurance to handle her cremation. And gave me an extra bit to move out on. Get another place secured somewhat. I said somewhat. And it wasn't easy. Water needs all the time. I had to walk this person step by step in the comments of how to deal with the beginning stages of it. I hadn't yet to walk this person down the road on what they're going to be dealing with. The person wants to find out why. The problem is you can find out the biology of why the body function broke down through the doctors and through the notes. But that doesn't tell you about what happened in the mental or the spiritual. Unless, of course, you're going back through the history of the person. And if you're really, really close with a person, if there was any notes left anywhere, it would probably give you an indication of how bad of a downhill slide we're talking. If the person was suffering through a medical condition that is not recoverable, curable, if there's no miracle left, then maybe it was voluntary or involuntary action taken on that final path. It's not that easy for me to talk about this one either, because I'd see my mother do the slow walk on this one. My brother, on the other hand, I don't know what the hell happened to him. Quick, didn't want to deal with anything else. All I get to do is yell at a damn corpse. With Mama, I got to kiss her goodbye. of seeing her like that. I couldn't. I really couldn't. I'm seeing my mother in her condition, and it was killing me. It was killing me. My brother's condition was the worst, because sudden, he's gasping for breath and he's getting an oxygen tube onto him, and he can't even get a trach tube down his throat. And by the time he rolls in through the, by the time I come around and get into the ER and go over to where he's been worked on, he's already dead. Tubes, leads, IVs. A war was fought. And he chose to die. And I understand more and more as I keep going over the memories of what happened, because my brother didn't want it. He hated it. The situation he got put into, and then seeing his brother take care of him. This was like utter humiliation for him. Had to have been. I gotta take care of grandma, I gotta take care of mama, and then I gotta take care of my big brother. David and I had taken care of each other like crazy up until the time he passes. I gotta take care of me. He probably still thinks I'm tough enough and strong enough, because I had to be. Tough enough and brave enough and everything else like a hero would be. I'm no fucking hero. That's my problem. I was never a damn hero. I was a guy getting my ass kicked left and right. How was I supposed to be? How was I supposed to know? I don't give a shit. I'm just getting through this stuff. My brother dies. I have to get through this stuff. Mama died previously, and I'm still working through the emotions. What's even worse is when I start having the relatives from the past start coming up and haunting me. Now I have to grieve about them left and right. Every one of them. And I gotta start grieving about the dogs that I've lost in my life. That I haven't given myself enough time to grieve over. Or mourn over. What is it, a short mourning period, a grieving period we have concerning about our lost loved ones? Is this how a society afflicts us? Or is this how we're trying to treat ourselves? Or who's putting all this damn stuff on our damn shoulders for us to follow these damn things? Once we're in pain, we're in pain. But everyone's got these books out there saying, you can get through this. You can be positive. You can. And the only thing I like to dig is a baseball bat to the damn theory and have fun with it. I mean, come on. I've been dealing with grief ever since the day I was born. I've been grieving ever since the day I was born, I guess. Grief about my own damn death and scared the fuck out of me. 4 years old. Heart operation on a damn table. You know what got to me? I was seeing a four-year-old that one of my neighbors has over here. And they're celebrating a birthday. A four-year-old's birthday. Highly obnoxious kid. Being a kid. Having his day, having his way for 4 years old. Thinks he knows things. Wait until he gets in school and gets himself into fights. Then tell me, what does he know about life? Or girls with rising hormones. You look at the life story about this kid. Is he going to make it, or is he going to be a hood ornament? I'm hoping maybe the kid will be smart enough to not be a pain in the ass, but apparently he's a pain in the ass. So he's going to have an interesting life. Mine, I was a quiet one. Always a sickly kid. I didn't have an interesting life. I had people picking on my ass because I kept showing weakness all over the place. You had to be strong. You had to show how strong you are, even to your age bracket. Oh, jeez. Mary and Joseph, the law of nature, law of the jungle. You had to fight like crazy. You couldn't show weakness. But according to our teachings, God helps those who are the weakest at this point over here. But if you're a bully and you're belligerent, screw it. That's it. You're in trouble. My brother and I were inseparable. Until he went in the Navy and became separated. Came out of it screwed up. More combat skills, but more screwed up in the head. It had taken him a long while to recover his soul and his mind, apparently, to back to nearly the way it was. But that didn't scare the hell out of me, because he was still my big brother. It was only the last 10, 15, 20 maybe, started telling each other we really loved each other, because we did. We had to work on that relationship. Brother to brother, watching each other's back. And we were the best of them. As we tried to be. We tried to be Marianne's sons. The sons of Marianne. In that movie, The Sons of Cutie Elder. Got sad in the movie. It was sad. But still, it ended with a little bit of hope. And not my particular situation, and not for the people I keep running into left and right regarding death. Because death is supposed to be the transition. Death is supposed to be everything. Well, we have heroes on the screen trying to tell us, oh, it's not so bad. It's not so bad. You want to talk about emotional shock? Give me a fucking break. The brain's going through so much at that point over there. So much that it's shutting its senses down and his logic centers down in order to cope what's going on, because it's dying. Everything's on a shutdown. And you're feeling the fear because you don't know what's going on next. I guess the only thing that was left is the fear center in your brain, because it doesn't know how to deal or how to cope or anything else. And then after that, you're supposed to feel this pop. You're above. You're coming out of the mortal shell, and you're supposed to feel wonderful. No, I was still terrified. A 4-year-old's terrified. Okay, he doesn't have the context. He doesn't have perspective. He doesn't have those two to understand what the hell's going on with him. All he knows is he's going back home, and he's going to hide there. Hide under someone else's bed so it doesn't get dragged out and be put back on Earth again. That was me. I'm put back down here and I'm still trying to figure the shit out still. Why does God still have me down here? I have no clue. All I know is there was a letter that pleaded to God. I'm still down here. Maybe because my brother didn't want me to leave. And if that's the case, He's gone. I'm mourning like crazy. Decades later. Mama's gone. I'm still mourning like crazy. My whole sibling and my old uncles and aunts are gone, and grandma and aunts, and they're gone. I'm left. I got the nieces and nephews out there. They don't know me. They don't want to know me. Nobody cares. No matter how many times I keep posting things out there, nobody gives a shit. I don't know how am I supposed to feel about this darn crap. How am I supposed to tell to people at this point over here when they're going through their grief on what they're expecting? There's no step-by-step instructions to tip out to get rid of the damn body. You go through processes. You have to go through the legal stuff. But emotionally, how do you deal with it? That's the hardest damn thing to figure out. How do you deal with that on a constant basis? We're all asking ourselves for that question. You know what I keep saying? Everyone's doing this, and everyone's got the hearts, and the teddy bears, and stuff like that. But it's not really telling them what exactly they're looking for. They're looking for step-by-step instructions on how to deal, and how to sort, and how to cope. Because they're having problems doing this shit. And the others are just too, I don't know, they just don't want to be bothered about it. They don't know how to talk about it. They don't know how to talk about their feelings at this point of what's going on inside of them. This is the reason why I keep telling people, journals, journals, journals. The only way to get your stuff out is through journals. Doesn't matter if it's an audio, if it's on paper, if it's on video. Because this gets the stuff off of here and off of here temporarily. Until maybe you can function. Me, I do these things in the morning because I'm narcoleptic. I have insomnia as well. I have sleep issues. They're driving me nuts. And they are driving me nuts at this point. How am I supposed to deal with it? I have to deal with it. I have to deal with it on a constant basis. I have to wake up in the morning and realize I'm not alive and I'm not awake and I'm going for my coffee sometimes. Or I just am too damn depressed or could care less about having coffee that time. Or about getting dishes done and seeing the damn roaches around the damn place. Some of the habits I've been getting, and they're rotten habits as well, is when we got into the COVID situation, I began to order bulk. Some stuff order for bulk. Because don't go to the store, order it for bulk. So that habit stays with me right now. It drives me crazy. I get stuff in bulk. I get powders. I get Gatorade in different flavors. I get Spam, I get noodles, I get cereal bars, I get cereal. I get cans of chicken for my dog because he can't stand the regular dog food I keep giving him. I get a lot of coffee and creamer and sugar. I get trail mix and I get bags of almonds to munch on. All without going to the store, by the way. If I need anything immediately from the store, I do a nice, lovely DoorDash, and I do walk, if I'm lucky enough, get over to the liquor store and get some the stuff I need, like extra milk, or perhaps some eggs or cheese, butter. But if it comes down for, like, rice, I can get a bag of rice, a huge bag of rice, or boxes of Rice-A-Roni, or mashed potatoes. Bags of that shit. Or a box, big bags, big box of crackers. as I said before, a whole flat. No, I don't get a whole flat of a liquor store. No, no, no. So I get stuff, weird stuff. Stuff I normally wouldn't do it, especially when my brother was alive. But the older I get and the longer it gets, the more weirder stuff I get that I usually don't get. And the stuff I'd like to get is like, you know, the usual chips and salsa and ice cream and bean dip. It's just... yeah. It's just weird. It's just weird. Huge containers of iced tea with lemon flavoring in it. Give me a lot of sugar in an hell damn thing. And I can drink it. Be my pseudo coffee. It's got caffeine. The sugar is gonna kill me with the damn diabetes one of these other days. All these nice little lovely distractions here. How about that one? Food. I turn into an Overeaters Anonymous situation. Whale on a beach. And yet the emotional situation is not solved. The pain is still there. The grief is still there. Temporarily elated and temporarily abated. But not gone. Some of these memes I keep seeing from different doctors or different quotes from different places saying about how much in time it's going to fade and you're going to function. And you're going to be this way. I'm looking at it like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I've been doing this all my life. Don't tell me about it. All my life, I haven't been allowed to grieve or mourn. I had to be in your sedated spots. I had to take your soma and space out. How about that one? Schmucks. Brave new world, my ass. When my brain is working, when my mind is working, when I'm actually able to use big words. When I'm actually able to tell people what's going on. The reason why I do the tapes is for my own memory's sake. But I know if people actually looked at the damn thing, they'll be seeing a guy going through this stuff. Someone hopefully they can relate to. I have to take it upon my personal responsibility here now. Not for someone else to wig it out, but hopefully for them not wigging out. I don't want them to wig out. It's bad enough when I'm trying to fight my way from wigging out. People have said I'm strong. I don't know what my strength is. All I know is I'm crying my eyeballs out when I get triggered, and I know that's weakness. Because when I get triggered once, I know there's going to be a lot of things out there ready to put me into the emotional tailspin. And then I'm going to be feeling the urge to go through the tsunami. I'll see a picture, an image, or hear a sound, or something. That's usually the last trigger, and then boom! It's like the first trigger is loading around into the chamber. And you're just waiting for the click. That's how it is for me sometimes. I don't have to hear it. You know, I'll hear the round going in, sliding in, ready to go. I don't have to hear that ching ching. No, because usually it's when I feel it. It's like, here comes the whoosh! Not again! Crying my eyeballs out. I'm crying my eyeballs out because the emotion of it hits me like crazy. I'm pleading to God not to take it away. I'm just pleading to Him. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry you have to see this. I'm sorry I'm going through this. I'm sorry. I don't even know why I'm sorry. I'm apologizing for something here. I'm apologizing for I don't know what it is. I'm just apologizing. Maybe God will look down on me and just say, yeah, he's a nut job already. Or maybe he has already seen why and how much level of grief I still have to pour out of my body. Maybe it's like a daily poison that still has to be leached out of me. And that the only way of doing that is by going through the crying, through the emotions. And if that's what I need to do, then that's what I need to do. Cry my eyeballs out. But the thing is, I keep recording. I keep talking about it. I have to keep talking about it. Because I'm hoping maybe somehow, someday, that someone's going to say, next time, lower your fucking boombox down, you asshole. Otherwise, we're having problems cranking up the volume. We can't hear you, you asshole. Maybe I'll be greeted that way. I forgot this damn thing was still up. This is what happens when you get started on shit like this. Things happen. And I gotta repeat this whole fucking thing again. Holy fucking crap.